Welcome to an example of determining all six trig function values given a right triangle. If we wanted to determine the six trig function values of angle A, here they're listed in a table. If you need the review, you may want to pause and take a look at these. Again, if we're referring to angle A, side A would be the opposite side, side C would be the hypotenuse, and side B would be the adjacent side. Again, if we're referring to angle A. Let's go and take a look at our example. Here, all of these trig functions refer to angle B. So here's our angle B. So the opposite side has length of 35. This side here is opposite the right angle. So the hypotenuse has length 37 units. And the adjacent side of angle B has a length of 12 units. So the sine of angle B would be the ratio of the length of the opposite side to the length of the hypotenuse. So we'd have 35/37. Remember, we should always try to simplify these fractions, but this doesn't simplify. Now the cosecant of angle B would be the reciprocal of the sine of angle B. So the cosecant of angle B would be 37/35. Now for the cosine of angle B, that would be the ratio of the length of the adjacent side to the length of the hypotenuse. So we'd have 12/37. Again, this doesn't simplify. The secant of angle B would be the reciprocal of the cosine of angle B. So this would be 37/12. And the tangent of angle B would be the ratio of the length of the opposite side to the length of the adjacent side. So we'd have 35/12. And again, the cotangent of angle B would be the reciprocal of the tangent of angle B, so we'd have 12/35. And again, none of these fractions simplify, but if they did, we would have to take the time and simplify each of them.